Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to show you some decimal word problems, and these are pretty standard. You'll see things like this cropping up pretty frequently. In the first one, Lou bought 3 cans of soup for 89 cents each, a box of cereal that cost $3.25, a gallon of milk that was $2.69, a 2-liter of Coke for $1.69, and a candy bar for 40 cents. How much did she spend on the food? And so you should try these problems on your own, see how you do, and then check your answers afterwards. And number two, if in the first problem Lou paid with a $20 bill, what was her change? Okay, so this is pretty straightforward. I think you could probably do this one if you have done any problems at all in the past. What's happening is we have 3.89 cents because she bought 3 cans of soup for 89 cents. Let's bring this up a little bit. Then she bought cereal that cost $3.25. She bought a gallon of milk for $2.69 and so forth. Those are just all the things that she bought. So you would just multiply 89 cents times 3 and then add the rest of those up to find out that she spent $10.70 on her food. And $20 minus that means that she had $9.30 left over for change. So there's a multiplication in there, there's a bunch of addition, and there's a subtraction to answer those two questions. Another one that's a really standard type of question is miles per gallon. So David drove $274. He drove 274.8 miles on 12.5 gallons of gas. What was his gas mileage rounded to the nearest gallon? So we're just going to, miles per gallon means we're going to take the miles and divide by the gallons. So it's a division problem. So let's take a look at that answer. Since we're asking about mileage, we're really asking about the miles per gallon or MPG. 274.8 divided by 12.5. Use a calculator to do that. And round it off, these little wavy lines mean approximately, we should have gotten about 22 miles per gallon. And finally, Bill has 24.75 feet of board. He is making frames that are 1.6 feet by 3.75 feet. Does he have enough wood to make 2 frames? How much does he lack or have left? So in this case, there's a couple of things that are important to think about. For each frame, we have to multiply the width and the length by 2. Because if the frames are 1.67 by 3.75, there's 2 of those, one on each side of the frame and one on each end of the frame, right? So we have to take 1.67 times 2 and then 3.75 times 2. We multiply those and then we add them together, and that gives us 10.84 feet for each frame. We want to know, does he have enough to make 2 frames? We're going to take that 10.84 times 2, and that gives us 21.68 feet needed for 2 frames. Now, we were told that he had 24.75 feet of board, so like number 2, wouldn't we just need to then do the subtraction to find out what's left over? He does have enough to make the 2 frames. He had 24.75. He only needed 21.68. And if we subtract, we can see that he had 3.07 feet left over after making those frames. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.